all of us are complicit in this. We seem to propagate a nature in our society that happiness is based on good circumstances. Happiness is based on things. Happiness is based on what I would perceive, and what many others would perceive, as shallow. And so, I mean, we know it's shallow. We know it's not significant. Like, our happiness is based on things that in the long run don't really matter. But, and we know that. We believe that. We understand that about ourselves, but we seem to find ourselves gravitating to those things anyway. Like, you know, nice house, nice car, nice job, things playing out the way we want them to. That's an indication of happiness, right? I mean, we're happy because life is good and life is wonderful. And I don't want to disappoint you in saying this. Don't misunderstand me, but let's be real. Marriages fall apart. Child-parent relationships fall apart. You know, parent-child relationships fall apart. I mean, you know, the job falls through. Things just don't always play out the way that we wanted them to. Things don't always play out the way that we hoped them to. And so here we are, standing in the midst of what we thought was going to provide happiness for our life, when in actuality it doesn't provide happiness in our life at all. It actually creates this false sense of hope and this false sense of security and this false sense of joy that as soon as one of the table legs kicks in and the whole thing falls flat, we're like, oh, I thought I was going to be happy. I thought things were going to go well. I thought things were going to be good. Now, we know that those things don't provide happiness, but we still place our trust in them. I got to ask you guys some serious questions. And in my faith, you know, like, the truth is I find happiness and joy and peace in Jesus. And you got to ask yourself that blunt question right now. Like, even if you're going to church and you have quote unquote faith, I mean, like, where are you finding your peace right now? Where are you finding your confidence? Where are you finding your trust in the joy and the happiness and those things? Like, where are you in that process? And if you're focusing on things that aren't going to last, then how's it going to fall apart? Like, where's your spirit? Where's your soul stand? Where's the fixation of your life? Because I tell you honestly, the fixation of your life will determine if it's going to last. If it's going to cave or it's going to laugh, if things are going to work or if they're going to laugh, you know, like, are they going to last? Are they going to carry you through? Now, I'm not telling you for a second not to place moments of joy and happiness in your family. I mean, absolutely. Yeah, families fall apart. But like, in the moment right now, like today, like, be present. Be present in every moment. Like, choose to today look at your surroundings, look at your job and be grateful for it. Look at the things that you're doing in this life, the difference and impact that you're making, and find joy and happiness in it. Realize that you are a father, a mother, a child, an aunt, an uncle, whatever position you find yourselves in, and realize that that matters, that can bring you joy, that can help you sustain life and just increase your happiness and your confidence and your peace. Like, really, where is it based? Where is it focused on? What has your attention? Answers to questions like this will determine the longevity of your happiness. And happiness, though fleeting, is rooted in joy, which can be permanent, which can be stable, which can be ceaseless, because joy is found in God alone. Joy is found in the love that Jesus has for us, the forgiveness, the grace, the mercy, all the wonderful things that unfold in our life because He cares so deeply and so much about us. Where do you stand? Where do you stand? I tell you, you will find joy and happiness in this life, but how and what you focus on matters so much. Be present, be right here, be right now, or something's going to happen and your happiness is just suddenly going to be drawn out of you, and you're going to be miserable. Guys, I love you. Find the right things to be happy about.